वेलकम टू सेठ विद्या मंदिर जूनियर कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस ऑनलाइन ऑडियो वीडियो लेक्चर। वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, आई मिस अलका चौबे टेकिंग फिजिक्स क्लास 12th एक्सप्लेनिंग चैप्टर 4 दैट इज थर्मो डायनामिक्स। वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स मूव ऑन आवर नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज रिवर्सिबल एंड इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस इन थर्मोडायनामिक्स। Welcome back students, let's move on our next concept that is reversible process. Here we can see the graphical representation of reversible process and the example of it. So let's move on the first reversible process. Let's understand the definition of reversible process in thermodynamics. A reversible process is a change in a retard or opposite direction. The path of the reversible process is same in the in the forward and reverse direction. That is what reversible process. Here the word is very clear. The path of the reverse process is same in the forward and reverse direction. And here the condition, the reversible process is a change is retard in opposite direction. What does it mean? It means, students, the initial state of the system can be restored. The initial state of the system can be reversed here. With the help of this graphical representation, you can understand. Here you can see at y-axis the pressure is present, on x-axis the volume is present. So here, students, you can see at point A the volume is V1, at point A the pressure is P1, it means the initial pressure, initial volume. At point B the volume is Vf, it means the final. And that time the pressure is also changes. It means, let I consider any inside of container, and inside of that container the volume, temperature and pressure of the gas molecules are present, and when we apply the external pressure on this piston and piston is moving in upward direction, then what happens, students? That time the expansion of the molecule is happened. So it means the expansion of the molecule is happened. You see, from initial to final the expansion of the molecule has happened, and inside the pressure is decreases, inside the pressure is decreases and the volume of expansion is increases. So this is what the cycle from A to B, and this process we can also revert. It means from A to B we can change this condition from B to A. See this arrow sign. With the help of this arrow sign you can understand the reversible process. Let I understand this process with the help of this example, so it is very clear for you. So let I consider, as you know very well, inside of the gas molecule is present inside of container, and there is a piston is present. Or let I consider the inside of that upward this piston, there is some mass is attached on it. The external weight of that mass is 50 gram, and inside of that pressure value is also little bit near to it. It means the external magnitude or internal magnitude of the system is same. The surrounding, the external surrounding and the internal system, the condition will be same. That type the pressure will be same. So it means the balance condition is happening. So that condition, student, the piston is not moving. Then after some time, if I remove this weight, some amount of weight from the piston, then what happens? So the first weight is remains on the piston, and this amount of weight is removed. Then what happens when this amount of weight is removed? The pressure is removed. It means initially the pressure is 50, then pressure is 40. That time this piston is moving in upward direction. It means the force is going in upward direction. Displacement is also happening in upward direction. We already have done this condition in the previous video. So displacement and the force is moving in upward direction. There is expansion of the molecules are happen. That time inside of the gas there is a pressure is going in downward direction. See, the pressure is decreases. The pressure is decreases inside of the intermolecule. Pressure is decreases and the volume is expand. So see here, this condition here you can see the volume is expand and the pressure is decreases. Volume is expand from initial to final, volume is expand, and here the initial to final pressure is decreases. So this condition is this. Again, students, we can revert this condition, because in this condition the path of the reversible process is same in the forward and reverse. Let's consider this is the forward condition. Now we can go for the backward condition and again move to the same condition. It means now the piston is in upward direction. Let take the piston again move in the rest condition at this state. Then students, again we are applying the some amount of mass on it. It means slowly we can add the mass on this piston. When slowly we can add the mass on this piston, what happens students, the volume is again decreases. That time the volume is what? Decreases. When we add the amounts of mass on this piston, the volume is decreases. It means the volume is decreases. From final to initial, the volume is decreases. See this arrow sign. This arrow sign, it means the volume is decreases. So that time the pressure is what? Increases. That time the pressure is what? Increases. Because from B to A we are moving. So it means slowly we can take this condition. Let we remove this mass slowly. So piston is moving in upward direction. That time the expansion of the gas molecules happen, and that time pressure is decreases. Let we add the some amount of weight on it. So slowly the volume of the gas is decreases. That time the pressure of the gas molecule is increases, because this molecule is experience the pressure on it. That pressure is nothing but the external pressure. When we are adding the amount of pressure on it, the amount of mass on it, so this piston is moving in downward direction. That time the force is going in downward direction. When the piston is moving in downward direction, when we are adding the amount of mass on it. So be very clear about it, students. Slowly we can increase the volume and slowly we can decrease the volume when we remove some amount of mass on the piston. It means the gas expands slowly. Why the gas expands slowly? Because slowly we remove the mass of the mass on the piston. It means slowly we can move the piston. That time, let consider the piston is very massless, that is the frictionless. We are taking frictionless? Because here we are driving force. It means here we are applying the driving force. The user is applying the force is known as driving force. The driving force is very small. So the frictionless piston is applying here. So no loss of heat is happened. Because students, in this condition, the volume expansion process or volume reduction process is very slow. At this slow condition, students, no loss of heat. It means if you are walking on the road, slowly you are walking on the road. It means the sweat is not coming from your body very fast. It means it's taking some time to remove the sweats from your body. Clear? So this is what the reversible process. And let understand some example of reversible process today. So here we have note the initial state of system. See, the initial state of system can be reversed, is known as reversible. Here the examples, these examples are very natural in our daily life. That's why students, here I consider the some example of reversible process. That is melting of ice. Students, you know it very well. This process are very slow. In this process, the emission of heat is very less. No loss of emission of heat is happened because this process is very slow. It means melting of ice. You know it, students, the melting of ice, this process is very slow. That time, there is no emission of heat. It means emission of heat is not fast here. Freezing of water. You know, students, it's taking time to freeze that water. And boiling of water. The boiling of water is also taking some amount of time. The condensation of steam, this is also taking time. So this all is a natural example, students. And this natural example is known as reversible process. So be very clear about it, reversible process. It means this process can be reversed. Melting of ice, it means nothing but the water. Again, we can take that water in form of ice. So this process is reversible here. So be very clear about it, students. What is the natural examples of the reversible process? So here I am taking the example of irreversible process. The irreversible process is exactly opposite to the reversible process. So let me understand first definition. A irreversible process is a change that cannot be retracted in reverse or opposite direction. In the previous condition, students, द रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस इज अ चेंज रिट्रैक्ट अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. वी कैन गो सेम पाथ इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. सी द सेम पाथ इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन बट इन इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस डेट कैन नॉट बी रिट्रैक्ट इन रिवर्स और अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. इट मीन्स द पाथ ऑफ एन इरिवर्सिबल थर्मोडायनामिक्स प्रोसेस इज नॉट सेम इन फॉरवर्ड एंड रिवर्स डायरेक्शन. Let understand this condition with the help of graphical representation. You see, in the reversible process, the path of the reversible process forward and reverse will be in the same direction. The path will be same direction. See, the path will be same direction. But here in this condition, the path is not same in the irreversible direction. So it means for the forward condition where the expansion of the molecule is happen, at that time, see, the forward and backward direction is not same. It means the path is not same. The path of when irreversible thermodynamics process is not same as a forward and reverse direction. There is a differences of their path. What does it mean? Let I explain with the help of this example so you can understand. The example will be same, students. The same condition, the gas molecule is present inside of container, and inside of container there is a pressure, volume and temperature are present, and on the piston there is some amount of mass is applied on it, and inside of it there is an internal pressure on the gas is also present, and there is external the amount of mass is present. So it means this is the balance condition. Now in this condition, students, we want to remove all mass together. It means I remove this all mass together. Let this mass is 50 grams, so I can remove this all mass together, and when we remove all mass together, drastically the piston is moving fast in upward direction. It means when we remove this mass, the piston is moving fast in upward direction, this expansion of the molecule is happened fast. But in this condition, students, what we are considered, we are removing this mass slowly from 50 to 40, then 40 to 30. That time the expansion is happened slowly. But here we are taking that 50 kg mass and we removed all masses together. So in this condition, the piston is moving fast in upward direction. The piston is moving fast in upward direction. The volume of expansion is fast here. And here you can see the volume of expansion is slowly, frictionless, no loss of heat. But in this condition, there is a permanent loss of energy. It means when anything is moving in fast, it means there is a loss of heat. When you are running fast, because here I am taking the example of walking. When you walk, students, the sweat is not immediately removed from your body. It's taking some time to remove. But here, when you start running fast, that time what happens? The sweats are initially, removed from your body compared to this condition is very fast. So this is what? This is a permanent loss of energy from the system. And due to the friction or dissipated force is happening. Because here, students, this process is very fast. Drastically, the force is moving in upward direction. So your total loss of heat of energy is very fast. It means all energy of heat is lost here due to the friction, because anything is moving very fast. The friction is happened with this ball, and that time the dissipated force is happened. It means the amount of heat force energy is moving it very fast in upward direction. So heat of dissipated force energy is happened. The inside there is a loss of energy of this system is also possible. So in this condition, students, now this condition is not back to the original position because we removed all the masses. Now this piston is not moving in the backward condition. So this condition is known as irreversible process. Hope you very clear about it, students. The initial path is cannot be reworked. It means when we removed all masses, the piston is not again back to this condition. So this is what the permanent change, the permanent loss of energy from the system. And here the friction is applied and dissipated forces happened here. So this is what irreversible process. Let's understand this condition from the natural example, students. So here we have the natural example, the object that was previously cold, object and never become cold again. and same as we can consider a hot object and they reaches at thermal equilibrium, it will be not hot again. It means at the equilibrium condition, at the thermal equilibrium condition, students, the cold and hot object again not back to the original position. It means the puncturing an inflamed balloon, it means when the balloon is got punctured, it is not again blow again. The tire rubbing our palm together, it means when the tire is rubbing their palm together, the tire is not again back to the original position. And the burning of candle, students, when the candle is burned, that time also you are not getting that candle again. It means this all is a natural process, this all is an irreversible process, and this process is not back to the original condition. It means naturally, students, we are getting this irreversible process in our nature very large compared to the reversible process. So be very clear about it. This condition is not back again the initial point. It means the initial state of the system cannot be reversed. So this is what the irreversible process, students, in thermodynamics. Hope it is very clear about it. Let again give the revision of it. In the irreversible process, the initial state of system cannot be reversed. In the reversible process, the initial of the system can be reversed. Here the some natural example: melting of ice, freezing of water, boiling of water, condensation of steam. Here the some natural example: the puncturing of an inflamed balloon, tires rubbing our palm together, burning candle. And any object when it is reaches to the thermal equilibrium, they are not back to their original condition. So be very clear about it, students. So till then, bye bye, students. Take care of yourself. Let's meet on next video.